Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Sonic Adventure 2. And today we are finally getting around to playing as Shadow. Oh, ain't he marvelous? Ain't he fast? Ain't he emo as hell? Actually, not so much emo as hell. There are a lot of people that criticize him for being too emo, but really? His character's a lot more deep than that, as you could have seen from the last cutscene before I decided to cut off the recording. He's got a lot of personal issues that we're going to be exploring over the course of the story. And most of it is from his troubled and interesting past. But we'll get to that when we get to it. For right now, we're just going to sit back and enjoy running amok. Oh, this is a fun little tube. So many bounce pads! Whee! From here to here to here to here. Let's see if I can grab this chow box really quick. There we go. Now here's an interesting question. Can I actually get up there with both of those things? Yeah, okay. I was wondering. I had just enough room. I'm glad they playtested. Well, that was retarded. I'm glad they playtested this level a little bit to see if the players would be able to get themselves stuck or not. There we go, making up for some lost time. Of course, I probably won't be able to get the best time without use of upgrades. I can try, though. That's what I thought. I thought I wouldn't be able to get up there. Invisible wall! Game doesn't like you doing things that would break it. Sometimes on this level, I can actually die. This is one of the first levels where death is actually really likely. And my method for doing this part is not to be repeated, this is just me being stupid. Whee! And all the way back, whee! Because you build a momentum every time. And off the thing. And down the other side, whee! Oh god. Oh come on, yes! Yeah, there we go. Let me hit these run pads. Up here. Down there. Through these. Around those. Speed jump. Yeah, there we go. I'm getting all tricky and whatnot on this level. Woo, woo, woo! That big glowing head is a reference to one of Sega's other games, by the way. And there's a couple other references to knights that are in this game. One of them is in the Chao Garden, but I don't think we'll ever get around to seeing it because it requires a lot of work to get it. Loop-de-loop! Woo! And hit these boosts, and I think that's the end of the level. Hooray! Oh god! Wow! Wow! Wow, Mr. Robot, wow! You just had to be that guy to me, didn't you? Jeez.
Here we go!
I was doing so good until that, like, completely anticlimactic ending.
That wasn't so hard.
I guess I get hit twice, so that was really bad. I did a lot of really cool tricky things that made it look good, but it was actually really bad. I spent too much time screwing around. Alright, Chow World. Now, I have done a couple things in between our last two playthroughs. First thing I did was I actually named the Chow thing I wanted because I figured out how to do it because you guys left a comment and you're all like, all you have to do to get the Chow name you want is be like, no, I don't want that name. Do you want a new name? No. And she's like, well, do you want to name the Chow yourself? And I was like, yes. Okay, there we go. That's what I was looking for. So this is Flair because he totally called it in the comments. He was like, I want you to name that one after me. So I did. And the other one over here, his name is... Can I wake him up? Eh, well, we won't see his name until later, I guess. I'll leave that a mystery. I've already told you guys what I wanted to name him, though. Egg quarters.
This is Rouge. I've located Eggman's base and will proceed to enter it now. I hate to say it. I guess I'm going to have to find that key first.
All right. This level's going to be very familiar because we had to do something like this in Knuckles' level. Of course, Rouge has her own little mechanic with the security cams that will be rotating around all these hallways. And in order to avoid the security cameras, you have to just hide in the darkness for a little bit.
The key may be buried. Did you find a digging tool?
Oh, we have to get the digging tool as well. I forgot about that. So we have to find, I think the iron picks somewhere. There's one, alright. But we are gonna have to get those pick nails. I just forgot they existed. Let me blow up this door. There they are. Nice. Pick nails! You can dig into the ground or walls. Select dig in the action window. So let me press the B button when you're on the air or in a wall. Okay. Now that we have those, we should be able to get the rest of these keys with no problem. I haven't even seen a security camera yet. Ow, center of the ring. Center of what ring? Oh, probably center of the ring of the main room. Wait a minute. It's in here. No, it's over here. Center of the ring. So it's center of the ring, somewhere up in here. I guess. No. It was a gorilla up there, though. Oh, wait a second. Oh, wow. I didn't even know you could dig into those. They don't look dig intoable. Okay, let's hide in the shadow. Let this guy pass. There he is. Security robot. Alright. Check this clue really quick. A skull. Wow! Wow, could you be any more nondescript? Okay, thank you, small thing, for telling us what we already knew. That's fine, I appreciate it. Okay. Let's go around this guy. As long as you stay out of their line of sight, it's okay. Ugh. A room with 8 flames. No, I'm not ringing a bell. Nope! Ow. I forgot those lock onto you. Oh, here we go. Got it. A room with 8 flames would be this. So I've just got to find where in the room of 8 flames this actually... I just burned myself. Like a boss.
It looks like there's no treasure here.
What the? Oh. Just digging in here? Are you serious? Well, okay. Maybe it's a little further up. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Whew! Well, I know it's somewhere in here. It's gotta be in the ground. I just didn't check enough of these places, apparently. This is annoying. I hate it when these things are in the ground. Wait a minute. Was that a skull?
It looks like there's no treasure here.
Hold up. It said a skull, right? I am so confused! It's obviously in here, and I saw a skull pop up, so... Oh, what in the world? Here, come on. Back on the ground. This is quickly becoming annoying. I know where it is. Obviously, it's in here somewhere. There's obviously something here, Rouge! Because you just said it, Rouge! Can you have the exclamation point over your head? What in the world? What in the world? I don't even... Hang on a second. Let's see if we can get another hint. Maybe that'll help. By the neck of a snake attached to the alt... Oh! I am the dumb. So it's probably gonna be... hang on a second. Oh, wait a minute. I think I get it. Hang on. It's gonna be up here. Jeez! That was finicky as hell! I had the right place, I just didn't have the exact location. I don't know how that is a C rank with how long it took me to find that last key, but whatever. Flustered. I'm flustered! I don't even want to go see Flare right now. Just, no. Just go back in your thing. I don't even want to see him. I'm just flustered. Flusterated.
It's a space transporter. The destination has been set to Ark? Wasn't that space colony shut down over 50 years ago? What's he doing up there anyway? Doesn't matter. It's my mission to find out what he's up to.
So already we're seeing that Rouge has more motives than just finding gems.
The space colony Ark. I have to locate the central control room that Shadow mentioned before he left.
And Dr. Eggman gets a space level fairly early compared to the heroes. Of course, this is the space colony shut down. The power's not on yet. We just basically just got here. This is a really cool level for that matter. Because we're basically getting a first look at this place. Switch. I'll use that. I already did that. Kaboom! Alright, upstairs. Over here. Flick the switch. And on we go. Oh, this is a little labyrinth in here. I remember this room. We need to get up on the second floor. Not destroy too many of these boxes. Ow! There we go. Jet engine. This allows you to hover when you hold down the A button during a jump.
Try hovering to fly over it.
This, of course, is equivalent to Tails' booster upgrade. Alright.
Grab a key. I think we're picking up a decent amount of collectibles. Head across this gap. Is that a bat? I'll take that bat. I notice there's a lot more evil pets in the Dark Story, which makes a lot of sense. I'm gonna go ahead and flick that switch. Jeez, everything's dark out here. Eh. At least it's a little quiet compared to the hero levels. Oh geez, I can target all these. Ooh! Awesome. Aw. Wasn't facing the right direction. Wee! Oh god! Got him. Now we're locked into this platform, so we can't get off of it until the end of the lift. So we're just gonna fly upwards, and target things, and basically do a little bit of rail shooter action. We don't really have to worry about dying on these so much. Except for in rare instances. I guess some of these you can have to worry about that on, but... Is that Big the Cat again? What the heck are you doing here? That's the second time you were just randomly hanging out. Big the Cat is from Sonic Adventure, by the way. He had really weird levels with... Fishy! Or no, it's not Fishy. Froggy! Yeah, that's it. It was Froggy. I remember now. I might have to do a Let's Play of that game too, but not anytime soon. I didn't like Sonic Adventure as much as Sonic Adventure 2. Sonic Adventure 2 is definitely the superior game. I mean, it's enjoyable, but it's just not the same quality. And some of the characters you have to play as in Sonic Adventure are annoying. Alright, there we go.
Yosh!
Yosh!
Piece of cake.
Yeah, we did pretty good that time. We only got hit like once, I think. So let's drop off some stuff for our buddy. We've already got a crap ton of emblems, by the way. Nearly up to 30. We'll probably be at 35 by the time we finish this, all the story missions. Give the dude a bat! Take your monkey! I didn't make a note about this earlier, by the way, but Dr. Eggman has the funniest run of all the characters, just because he isn't designed for this at all. It's just kind of like... Especially because when all the characters are in Chao Garden, they all run at the same speed. Like, Sonic will run just as fast as everyone else, and he runs really fast in Chao Garden. But Dr. Eggman will be able to run as fast as Sonic. So here, let me demonstrate this. Oh! Like, look at his legs going all over the place. Like, arcing at really ridiculous angles. It's hilarious. I wish you could do run stages as Dr. Eggman. It'd look really funny. Oh, boy.
I've been waiting for you, Doctor. Now, I will show the glorious achievement of what the world's leading scientist, Professor Gerald, has created. The Ark was the first space colony created by mankind. Not many people know that the Ark contained a top-secret research facility where weapons of mass destruction were being created. This is one of them, a weapon capable of destroying an entire planet, codenamed the Eclipse Cannon.
Destroying an entire planet?
Was this my grandfather's legacy?
But it's been deactivated for some time now. To reactivate it, large amounts of energy are necessary.
Oh, so that's why we needed the Chaos Emerald.
Exactly. To reactivate the machine, we need the 7 Chaos Emeralds. Once you have that, then you have the ultimate power of destruction to use as you please. And then, the world could be yours.
Sounds like a plan. I like the way you think, Shadow. I will get the Chaos Emeralds, use the machine to dominate the world and build a legacy of my own.
Do you really think it will be that easy? I've got a great idea. How about making a deal?
A deal?
When you grabbed that huge emerald, you said something about a reaction. A reaction that it may have with the Master Emerald. Now, if you could just let me borrow that radar, I may be able to help you. What do you think?
If I do, what's in it for me?
I have an idea where the other Chaos Emeralds may be. It may not look like it, but do you know that I am a treasure hunter that specializes in all kinds of jewels?
Very well.
Okay then, it's a deal. I don't think we've been introduced. I'm Rouge the Bat, but you can call me Rouge.
Ulterior motives!
Having to come back isn't my idea of a vacation. How can you be sure your intelligence reports are correct? Why would the Chaos Emeralds be here on the island? Are you absolutely sure?
Well, believe what you want to believe.
Very well, very well. Let's discuss how we are going to do this. I will go in first and distract the military troops, allowing you to sneak in the base without being detected. Then, Shadow will enter the armory, where he will set the timer on these dynamite packs. Once that is in place, we will blow up the whole island and get away before anyone has a chance to know what hit them. Meanwhile, you'll have to sneak into the cargo area and grab the Chaos Emerald. That's a challenge for such a worthy treasure hunter as yourself, isn't it, Batgirl? We only have 30 minutes to pull this mission off, and we only get one try, so don't fail me!
Weapons bed. Oh god, this is a fun level. We get to literally play as Dr. Eggman and go around the base blowing up as much shit as we possibly can. The lock-on combos we're going to be able to get are ridiculous. Like, I'm getting so many perfects, it's insane. But this is pretty much what this entire level is. It's just running around and doing this. We need to find a cannon. Ah, there we go. The large cannon! Vulcan cannon power-up. You can now break iron containers that you couldn't break before. So not only that, but we also have the improved version of the Vulcan cannon for Dr. Eggman already. So we're going to just be making a mess. Ooh, don't want to get hit by missiles. It's enjoyable to cause a lot of carnage like this. Let me speed through here. When we come to another carry- Oh god, you almost knocked me out of the sky there, buddy. Let's just carefully blow away those boxes. Indeed I have. I think there was probably a secret or something back there. Here we go. We can do it again. Let's target all of these things. Wee! Carnage and destruction. Could have gotten a better multiplier off of that one, but eh. Okay, continuing. Ooh, let's not hit that. Oh, well, sure, hit the other one, that's fine. Hit these balloons for a little extra bounce. Okay. Ow! Military does get a little angry with you later in this level. They start sending a lot of dudes to stop you. Okay, I'm not gonna blow up all these because I wanna use... Oh, there's jump pads down there. Oh well. Whoop! Be a little careful so we don't get knocked out of the sky by anything. Speed limit strongly enforced. Ah! Got a good shot on me there. Let's jump from here to here and keep on going. Wah! And blow up all these. And blow up all these. And blow up all those. These carriers are not amused. Ah! Quit it. I don't even know where the heck this is supposed to be coming. Oh god! Phew! I'll just blow all those up. I don't give a crap! Whoa! God! Military is not amused! Come on, Dr. Eggman, go! We need to get this level done. We're making a mess. Ah! Okay. Phew! That was crazy.
That wasn't so difficult.
And with that, guys, I think that's going to be end for now of this. We're going to come back next time and play around with Shadow and Rouge and see what their goals or objectives in the mission are and how good they are doing them. But so far, the military base is under wonderful attack, and they're all going to die. Horrible, terrible, painful death. Also, if it wasn't evident, you know how the island blows up now in the hero story. It's called C4! C4 make big explosion. Yes. Very good. Alright. See you guys later.